Hello friends, welcome to Mechanical Engineering online classes.
Let us see how to find moment of inertia of a composite figure. Sometimes a question may come for a shaded area, means for the given figure, he will shade to ask us to find the moment of inertia or centroid of composite figure. So only for the shaded entity we have to find the moment of inertia. So here shading is not given in the current question, this one. So whether there is a shading or not, we can see the outline of the figure. The outline of figure is like this. Alright, so we have to find moment of inertia of this particular portion about the given x axis and the given y axis. So provided we know the dimensions of the entity. If the dimensions are not given, we may assume that this 30 centimeter has some height h, this has some a, and this has some b. So if nothing is known, we can assume it that way by common sense. But otherwise, if at all a particular value is given, we will have to take it that way only. So here composite figure means, like we have already discussed, it's a combination of several figures. So the given object or the given entity is obtained by clubbing four different entities. So here I am splitting the given figure into four parts. First is a triangle. Let me name this as entity 1. The second is a rectangle. I'm naming it as second one. Then next is another triangle. I'm naming it as a third one. The fourth entity is the semicircle. Let this be the fourth one. So the given object can be formed by adding 1, 2, 3. So this is 1 plus 2 plus 3, and by subtracting the fourth one. So it is 1 plus 2 plus 3 minus 4. So if this area, this portion is removed, then what we obtain is this one, the given figure. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 minus 4 gives us this. So we can do it in the other way also. I am picking up the entities this way, but otherwise this the same given entity can be obtained by considering a major rectangle. In this there are entities like this, so I can consider that major portion as rectangle 1. Then I have to minus this triangle, which is 2. Second triangle is this one. Third triangle is this one. Alright, the fourth semicircle is this one. So I can write it as 1 minus 2 minus 3 minus 4. So that way also we will get the given quantity, given entity, this figure. So we can do it in any comfortable manner. So I'm comfortable with this because I don't want to consider some other big rectangle then subtracting things out. No, I want to just use the entities that are there to, that are used to build up this particular given entity. So I'm using these four quantities to solve the problem. If you want, you can pick this way also. If you can find some other way also. So how a quantity can be generated, it has its own ways. So I'll use these four quantities to solve this problem here. So let us first find the moment of inertia of the composite figure about x-axis. X-axis here is the base of the, is along the base of the composite figure. If we carefully check, the x-axis of the composite figure, which is coinciding with the base of the composite figure, is actually coinciding with base of every individual figure as well. So if we are taking entity 1, 2, 3 and 4, all of those have their bases coinciding with x-axis. So ix of first figure, let it be say ix1, this can be given as the x-axis is here and the y-axis, given y-axis is somewhere here for entity 1. So for entity 2, the y-axis is here. For entity 3, the y-axis is somewhere here. For entity 4, y-axis is somewhere here. So ix1 can be written as, in case the base is say b1, height is say h1. So moment of inertia of triangle about its base is given as bh cube by 12. So we can write it as b1h1 cube by 12. For a rectangle, it is ix2, ix of second entity. Moment of inertia of second entity about x-axis is nothing but bh cube by 3. So let this be b2, this is h2, it is b2 h2 cube by 3, and this is b3, this is h3. So we'll have the moment of inertia about x-axis of figure 3 is b3 h3 cube by 12, and for a semicircle ix4, ix4 is moment of inertia about x-axis for fourth entity, it is nothing but pi, let this be, let the radius be say r4, fourth entity, or it's simply r also, we can write it r. This is pi r power 4 divided by 8. So if ix is the moment of inertia of the composite figure about x-axis, this can be given as ix1 plus ix2 plus ix3 minus ix4. So what is b1 and h1 from the given question? B1 is 10. H1, H2, H3, they are all the same, 30 cm. So H1, H2, H3 are given as 30 cm. And B1 is given as, B1 and B3 are 10 cm. And radius R is given as 10 cm. Diameter 20 is given here. So I am taking radius as 10. So if we substitute b1, h1, b2, h3, b3, h3 and r4, we can find ix as 10 into 30 cube by 12 plus 20 into 30 cube by 3. B2 is 20 from the question, this one, this 20. X3 is 10 into 30 cube by 12 minus pi into 10 power 4 divided by 8. So on solving this, we get the value of Ix, means moment of inertia of the composite figure about given x-axis. And Ix comes out to be 221073.0092. So I'm rounding it up here. Or I can write it 0.01. This is centimeter power 4. Everything is in centimeter. So I will be in terms of centimeter power 4. So this is Ix. So now let us find the moment of inertia of the composite figure about yy axis. Here we have to be very careful because in the previous case when we found MI about x-axis, the x-axis of the composite figure is coinciding with the x-axis, I mean about base of every individual figure. But here if we carefully look at all the three individual entities, the y-axis are at different locations to different entity. Like if we compare the composite figure with entity 1, the first triangle. So y-axis is passing through its centroid for the composite figure, but for triangle 1, the y-axis is offset to its length that is along h, or offset to any its centroidal y-axis. So here, if I am considering the triangles, say for the first and third, because they are equal, they are of same size and shape, it is the same B and H, and it is equally away from the given y-axis also. I mean to say, if this is 10, this is also 10. So one triangle is here, the other triangle is just a mirror image. So there's a symmetry. So if I find one, I can find the second also easily. So that's the reason here, if you see, IX1 and IX3 are same, because it is the same triangle, which is just a mirror image. Fine, so here also it is the same. So if I find IX1, I have IX3 also. IX1 will be equal to IX3, or IY1 will be equal to IY3. Let us find what that IY1 or IY3 is. Moment of inertia about y-axis of entity 1 or 3. So I'm first finding IY for the first entity only. So here, how do we find it? The triangle is like this. This is the given y-axis is somewhere here. So if we see, this is 10, this is given. This is also 10, that is also given. So here we can find moment of inertia of this particular triangle, either about this particular edge, or we can find its centroid, and about this centroidal y-axis also we can find. So we'll be finding I about either this centroidal y-axis or about its base, that is the length h, because about yc1 or y1 only we have formulae. We don't have formulae for something else. So if we know yc1 or y1, we can use the transfer formula, or applying parallel axis theorem, we can find iy about any other axis parallel to a centroidal axis. So this is the reason why we can find the centroidal location first, and axis through that centroid is centroidal axis. We will find IYC1 because we have the formula. Now we shall apply the parallel axis theorem to find IY. So for a right triangle, the centroid will be somewhere here. So if this is H, this will be H/3, or otherwise if this is B, then this will be B/3. So hence this distance will be 10/3, means 3.333 something. So our centroid G1 is at a distance of 10 plus 10/3, which is nothing but 13.33 from the given y-axis. So now we have obtained the centroidal location. It is the distance between yc1 and y is 13.33, which is nothing but d. So now, according to parallel axis theorem, we can find IY of the triangle as BHQ by 36, which is nothing but this is a moment of inertia of triangle about its centroidal axis. It is IYC plus A into D square. A is the area of the triangle and D is the distance between the two parallel axes. We have I about YC1. We want I about Y using I about YC1. So the distance, perpendicular distance between YC1 and Y is D. So if you want, you can check back with our parallel axis theorem. The video lecture is available. So using that parallel axis theorem, also called as transfer formula, we can find IY of the triangle. So this can be given as B is nothing but B is what is the dimension that is parallel to the axis under consideration. Parallel to axis is H. So in place of B, we have to substitute the value of H. That means B is 30 into H cube. H cube means, according to formula, H is the dimension that is perpendicular to axis under consideration. Here the axis under consideration is Y. So the perpendicular dimension of the entity is 10. So here H is 10. So BH cube means 30 into 10 cube. Don't blindly write 10 into 30 cube. No. So whenever you are, even if you are by hearting or mugging up the formula, always remember that when you say B, B is a dimension which is parallel to the given axis under consideration, and H is perpendicular dimension, that is for perpendicular to the axis under consideration. So here B is along y-axis and H will be perpendicular to y-axis. So perpendicular dimension to y is 10, along dimension along y is 30. So likewise we have substituted. So 30 into 10 cube by 36 plus area of the triangle is half into base into height multiplied by d square is 13.33 square. So solving this, we get IY of one triangle as 27486.67 centimeter per 4. This is for one triangle. Because we have two triangles, we can find IY of both triangles. So that will be 2 into IY of one triangle, that is 2 into 27486.67. So this comes out to be 54973.34 centimeter per 4. So both the entities we have considered. Now we have to consider the rectangle and semicircle. So let us look at this rectangle. It is 20 by 30 size. And if we carefully look at it, the given y-axis and the centroidal y-axis of the figure are coinciding. So we don't have to apply parallel axis theorem because it is not the case unlike the triangles where the centroidal y-axis is offset to the given centroidal y-axis of the composite figure. They are offset by a distance d, so we had to apply this formula where ad square in that d we had to substitute. But if at all the centroidal y-axis of the individual entity is coinciding with the centroidal y-axis of the composite figure, the distance between that yc and y is 0, d is 0. So it will be the moment of inertia about its centroidal axis only. D is 0, right? So we can straight away apply the formula. So IY of the rectangle can be given as BH cube by 12. This is a formula. So Ig formula is used. We are straight away using the Ig formula. Because Iy of the rectangle is nothing but Ig of the rectangle. Why? Because the centroidal axis of the rectangle is coinciding with that of centroidal y-axis of the composite figure. So the distance between two axes is zero. So even if you want to write AD square, this is zero. So entire term becomes zero. So ultimately it comes out to be BH cube by 12. So now here also we have to see what is B and what is H. This is 20, this is 30. So y-axis is this. The dimension that is parallel to the axis is B. So here 30 is parallel to y-axis. So B is 30 multiplied by 20 is perpendicular. The perpendicular dimension is H. Height is perpendicular. So it is 20 cube divided by 12. So 30 into 20 cube by 12 comes out to be 20,000 centimeter per 4. Now let us see IY of semicircle. So from the given figure, the centroidal y-axis of the semicircle is coinciding with the centroidal y-axis of the composite figure. So there also straight away we can find IY of semicircle as IG of semicircle, because they are coinciding. D is 0. So therefore we can apply the formula. The formula goes like this: pi r power 4 by 8. So because we know r value, r is 10, so this comes out to be 3926.99 centimeter per 4. So now IY of the composite figure will be nothing but IY of both triangles plus IY of the rectangle minus IY of the semicircle. So IY of both the triangles is this one, 54973.34 plus this one, 20,000 minus this. All the four entities are considered. So ultimately this comes out to be 71046.349, or I'm taking it as 35 centimeter per 4. So this is IY of the composite figure. We have already found IX of the composite figure. Now here we have found the centroid of an individual entity or composite figure only when necessary. For the given question, wherever necessary, we have found the centroidal location. Now suppose the question is to find moment of inertia about the x and y centroidal axis of the composite figure. If the question is about finding moment of inertia of the composite figure about its centroidal x axis and centroidal y axis, in case that time we have to first locate the centroid of the composite figure. How to find centroid of composite figure is already uploaded, but I'll tell you in short, because that also is needed sometimes. Centroidal x-axis is, if suppose we are finding the centroid of this particular composite figure, suppose that has come out to be somewhere here is G. So that time this is the xg and this is the yg, the given y-axis. Here in this question, the given y-axis itself is the centroidal y-axis, because the given figure is symmetric about y-axis. So a symmetric axis is the centroidal axis. The centroid lies on the axis of symmetry, right? So that's the reason here in this particular figure, the centroidal y-axis and the given y-axis are same. But in case the question is to find moment of inertia of composite body about centroidal x-axis also, so that time we have to take first triangle we have taken. This is the first entity, the x is here. We have to find the centroidal location of this. Let that be g1. Now find this ixg of the first entity. Now apply parallaxis theorem. Find the perpendicular distance between these two. And then you have to ig plus ad1 square. You have to apply this. Just like how we have done for iy of a triangle. Here in this particular question, it is asked to find moment of inertia about x-axis. The x-axis is passing through base of the triangle, both in the composite figure and individually also. So we didn't need to find any d1, d2, d3 and so on. So they are all coinciding. So all the d1, d2, d3, d4 are zeros. So straight away the formula we could apply. But in case the question is to find about centroidal x-axis, then we have to follow the same procedure like how we did here. Alright, so this is one important thing that we have to keep in mind while solving a problem. In case a centroidal axis is required to be found out, we have to first find the centroid of the given composite figure using the formula. And then we have to apply the parallaxis theorem for both the rectangles and for the triangle and for the semicircle also. For all the four entities, we will have to apply for parallaxis theorem to find ig about x-axis for the composite figure. So even for the rectangle also, we may have to apply parallaxis theorem because the centroid of rectangle is its center. But this g2 might not be coinciding with g of the composite figure. So wherever it is not coinciding, for all of those we'll have to apply the parallaxis theorem and then solve the problem. So that time our problem will be split into two major segments. First segment is to find the centroid first. Find the centroid of individual entities and find the centroid of the composite figure. So if they are not coinciding, so wherever it is not coinciding and wherever necessary, we may have to apply parallaxis theorem for everything.
Thanks for watching. If this video was of help to you, please like it and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel.